Hello and welcome to the next Outdoor Office podcast. We are Anthony and Jamie.
Mm-hmm.
We still decided, us. We decided that we were going to start this podcast with a very important question.
Is this like a PSA?
Yes.
Public service announcement.
It's a question that I think comes with some pretty strong opinions, I would say.
Oh, wow. We're going controversial.
Yeah.
Okay.
Anthony has mentioned before that he finds a lot of his inspiration through books. So it got me thinking, what kind of person are you? Are you a book reader or are you an audiobook listener?
Are you talking to me?
I would like to actually know this answer from our listeners as well. So please comment.
Do it.
But yes, I am talking to you. Are you a book reader? I know this
answer. What was the question? I wasn't paying attention.
Oh my gosh. Are you a book reader or an audiobook listener?
I do both.
Yep.
Did you know that answer?
Yep. We shouldn't even have the podcast. I knew this.
All right. Well, have a good day. I do both. I use Audible a lot. And so for me, either I'll see a book on there that's like something that kind of piques my interest, and then I'll actually buy the book. And then while I listen to the Audible, I'll actually read the book along the same time. Or I'll see a book that I really like and I'll double check to see if there's actually an Audible available. And then I'll kind of do it that way. I tend to have it really sink in when I do both. And sometimes, to be honest with you, I don't always have the ability to sit down for periods of time to read. Sometimes I can just listen to an Audible while I'm, you know, doing something in between, or like while I'm driving. Like I listen to, while I'm on the road, a lot of audiobooks. So I'll, you know, if I'm driving to, you know, a job site, or if I'm driving to, you know, scout somewhere or do whatever, you know, if it's a couple hours or an hour, whatever it may be, I'll take that time to listen to an Audible and I'll crank through a couple chapters. And so I like that. I also like it when the writer or the author of the book is also using, you know, they're using Audible themselves.
See, here's the opinions. Here they come.
Well, I just, you know, it sounds better to me because it sounds like they're actually physically telling their story, which they are when they're reading the book, you know. But sometimes you get, some of you, if you listen to them, there's some Audibles out there where it's like, wow, that's a really painful book to listen to. The book itself is great, but you're like, wow, they need a different narrator.
Yeah.
Which is probably what they say about me in this podcast. So, you know, they like you and they listen to a lot of your comments, which is great. But, yeah, so I that's what I tend to do. I don't know. I mean, what do you do?
Well, this is why this question was very important to me, because I tend to do neither. I really struggle with, one, finding the time to just read. I love actually having a book in my hand.
Do you read books through watching TV?
Yes.
Good.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. I love actually having a book in my hand. I love sitting down and reading the book. But I tend to not prioritize reading, or finding that time
you
to read.
You do like crosswords.
I don't like crosswords. I like word finds.
Word finds. <Yeah. laughs> That's right. Because crosswords require you to know words.
This one is just, it is.
You like to circle.
Uh-huh.
It's true.
It's the OCD in me. I like to make the circles really nice and clean too.
Do they have audible word searches?
Oh, that would be pretty funny.
Okay.
So anyways, I like to read. I just don't prioritize my time to do so. But then I also, I mean, like you said, you actually prioritize your time to even listen in the car. I before this podcast, I walked into your office and you were listening to one while you were working.
A podcast?
Yeah. Or yeah. Was it a podcast?
That was a podcast.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so I've gotten into, I never really did, but, you know, there's a few out there that are interests of mine that I like to listen to what they're talking about and,
yeah,
you know, try to go from there and get some inspiration on maybe what we do here and how we're going to do some things and what we talk about, and realizing that, you know, it may or may not always be on a specific subject about, you know, Outdoor Office or the company, but it all sends to some somehow relate back to kind of what we believe in or what we stand for, or also just, you know, topics that are out there that, you know, we're here for.
Yeah. So you already answered kind of one of the questions, which was, when do you actually make the time to do it? Which you said driving, and then obviously sometimes while you're in the middle of, you know, some work that you can listen to.
Yeah. So sometimes, like, when I'm sitting at my desk for a while, I'll try to listen to that. But the hard part is, if I get too much into the work, I can't actually listen to what's going on.
And then you have to rewind and listen.
Yeah. And I kind of go through it that way.
Is that the right word?
I don't know. You were the one joking about,
that. Yes.
You're the one joking about, like, do they still have books on tape?
Like, do people still say, cause there's a time I was going to find, an audiobook for our boys to listen to before bed. And I mentioned, book on tape instead of,
she goes, is there a book on, maybe I can find a book on tape. And it's like, book on tape.
Yeah.
I mean,
that's how, yes, techie I am.
Yeah. Wow.
Tape.
Okay. Well, you know,
But then I guess to lead into, cause I want you to actually talk about some of the books that you read, but
that are not on tape.
That are not on tape.
Okay.
Yes. But first talk about what types of books.
Yeah. It's like general genres of books, I guess.
Yeah.
You know, for me, I, obviously follow a lot of, military books, a lot of special operations, ex-special operations, people who have gotten into this world to kind of tell some of their stories or leadership or whatever that may be. So it kind of ties into leadership. It ties into, you know, business and operations. It also ties into the mental side of things. You know, it's always, a lot of people like, you know, hearing stories about stuff like that. I usually tend to pull out of that the mental fortitude it takes for a lot of these operators to do what they did. It also takes a lot of risk and something deep inside you that requires you to do something different than what the norm is. So that also applies to entrepreneurs. You know, I mean, that's who I am. That's what I am. And, you know, as far as my concept of how things work in my head is that I'm often willing to do things that other people aren't. So, you know, I look at business books, I look at leadership books, I look at military books. And so that's kind of where I don't really read whatsoever, like science fiction or, you know, any kind of anything in that world. It just doesn't often interest me. And I think a lot of that goes back to when I think about it, you know, I didn't, you know, maybe I didn't have much of a childhood, I don't think. You know, so like I was never into, like, at least far as I can remember, I wasn't really into like a lot of kid things, you know. I mean, when I was young, my youngest memories of watching TV was like watching MacGyver and watching
you know
like Home Improvement, and you know, I mean, these were like shows that I watched.
Yeah, when we first started dating, I had to introduce him to the world of Disney.
Yeah, I don't know if I'd ever really seen any Disney movies.
Little Mermaid, that was a must.
Certainly,
Lion King.
No.
Yeah.
None of those.
Ones that I watched on repeat where you had to rewind it to watch it again.
Yeah, no. I watched Top Gun. I watched you know, a lot of movies more along that realm.
Right.
That, you know, maybe shaped and molded me more about, you know, what I am today. But yeah, that's kind of what I tend to be interested in.
Yeah.
You know, and that, I think obviously, you know, being in that world for almost a decade, it, you know, is something that, there are aspects that I miss, you know, for sure. But, you know, I think the reality is now it's more about learning, you know, taking those lessons learned and how to apply them into, you know, this world that we're in now, as far as growing and running a business and having teams and having people, you know, rely on you for decisions and leadership. I think that's where I'm trying to gather those tools and have that available for me to be able to access when I need to, when the situation matters. Mm-hmm. So it's kind of like, you know, doing training. It's just a different way to do it now.
So it's not, you're not really into like the self-help type genre.
No,
it's more educational documentary type things that you learn from other people's experience.
Yeah. I mean, I think for me, I was always kind of you know, from an early age, I was always kind of taught, listen to your elders, you mm-hmm. know, I mean, they have a lot of life experience, you right. know, and I don't mean elders to be rude as like old people or anything like that. It's not, it's just some people have more experience right. in certain areas.
Somebody who's gone through the experience before you.
Yeah. I mean, they can be younger than me,
right.
you know, but it's like they have 15 years experience in this area right here. I think you'd be stupid not to listen to what it is that they're saying.
Right.
You know, and they have good insight and they have a lot of lessons. Generally speaking, a lot of us who are entrepreneurs or who've been in, you know, anything in defense or military and like that, it's like there's been likely a lot of hard lessons learned.
Right.
And so I think that's where I'm trying to listen to what their experiences were. And I'm fascinated by some of that and, mm-hmm. and not fascinated like, oh my gosh, that's so exciting. Fascinated in, you know, what they went through and how they either overcame it or what decisions were made to help right. them do that. That's what I get really. I geek out on that because I want to learn, well, why did it work here and what didn't work there and what caused it here?
And you how know, I really you can apply
to,
it.
Yeah. I mean, this is, if you know me, I mean, I'm very analytical and that's yes. what I analyze is right. that this is my brain and how I work is I analyze all these situations and play out all these scenarios. So mm-hmm. when people come to me and they ask about, you know, hey, what do you think about doing this? Generally, by the time they come to me, I like to be very well prepared. Or if I'm not, then I like to pause and go away and do my analysis on it. And I'm going to run every scenario I can possibly think of.
Right.
And that comes from my experience, but it also draws off other people's. And that's right. where sometimes for me, like knowledge is power. It's knowing what other people have gone through and what maybe they've experienced. That is something that I try to really take a lot of value in
mm-hmm.
so that when the time comes, I can try to make as much of an informed decision off of what I know. And I mean, I the first one to tell you is like, I've made plenty of mistakes. I will continue to make plenty of mistakes. I'm just trying to figure out how to not make the same mistakes.
Right.
And if there's something that I can learn from someone ahead of time that can set me up, then, you know, to put me in that right frame of mind, then fantastic. So asking questions, you know, like that's what like audiobooks and reading some of these books, it's a way for me to be able to kind of almost ask the questions without having to ask a question. I'm just able, because I'm not able to, you know, like I listen to, you know, and read, you know, like Jocko Willink and, you know, yeah. like I listen to a lot of these, like Simon Sinek and, you know, like a lot of people know their names, right? Mm-hmm. I'm probably never going to meet them or have communication with them. You know, if I could, great. Like I would sit down and ask them, you know, certain things and just communicate to them. They're not any different than I am, you know, right. they just have a special set of ability that I maybe don't have that I would like to learn from, yeah. you know, and see how that can be handled in a different way. And then now maybe if I can do that, I can pass that on to the next person as well. And I think that's where a lot of leaders, really good ones, figure out ways to not just learn all of that knowledge, they figure out ways to use that knowledge and educate the next people in line. So that knowledge gets getting passed down. You know,
right.
I think that's where we've all had coaches or leaders or bosses or whoever who they may have a wealth of knowledge, right? And they have no ability to communicate that or teach that.
Mm-hmm.
And that generally sucks for most people. You yeah. know, I mean, if you've ever gone through that and it's like, you know, they've got all this experience in the world, but they have no idea how to communicate that to someone. Man, that sucks because you just, it's like if you could only figure out how to get into your brain and do that,
yeah.
you know, that's so anyways. Yeah, I mean, it's a long-winded answer, you know, which is a typical, you know, thing for me. But
maybe no. you should write the book.
Yeah, I don't know about that. I've had many lives, I feel like, yeah. at this point. Yeah.
Our friends joke quite a bit because of the experience that you've had. And it does sound like you've had many lives. Because of, I mean, you put yourself in those situations. You've always tried to try different things, learn different things. And yeah, I think it'd be pretty interesting if you actually wrote a book of all the things that you've done.
Yeah, it'd be interesting. Like almost like if you did like a podcast or something like that. I'm like, okay, we're going to talk about what have you done in your life, right? And it's like, man, I don't know if I have enough episodes for that. But
yeah
I mean.
Do a timeline.
Yeah, a timeline. I'm like, man, I don't even know if I've done that. But yeah. So, I mean, those are the kind of books. I mean, like for you, I mean, do you even have books that really interest you? I mean, like, what do you?
Yeah. You know, I used to be someone who read mostly fiction, just to read on my off time. then I had kids and a little less time to read things like that. And I became more interested in kind of the same thing that you're talking about more. How can I learn from other people's experience? And as of right now, I feel like I'm kind of in the phase of like parenting books, to be honest. Like, mm-hmm. I know our kids are older, so it's not like the young parenting books. It's
they're 12 and 9.
Right.
Yeah, so, I mean, they're kind of that mid-age.
Yeah, we have one that's, you know, a preteen, mm-hmm. Very much teenager. So, you know, it's books like that I'm more interested in. That again, I want to learn from other people's experience, not just like a how-to book, not a self-help book, but more of, here's what worked for us, or this is, something that we feel is successful, for many different scenarios. That's what I'm interested in right now, mm-hmm. so that I can actually apply something like that, to try to work on. I think that's what, I think you like as well, is if you read something and it sticks with you and you actually go, oh, I can actually try that right now. Or you think about it a couple days later or a week later or whatever. And you realize, oh, I've been applying what I've read. That's pretty cool. So that's kind of what I'm more interested in than, like I said, you know, I do love to be entertained and read fiction books, but I just don't, I'd rather spend my time, the little time that I have, if I am going to read, with books that I think could help me just be better at something.
Like they have a value to you.
Right.
You know, where, you know, more power to the people who read a book and they can kind of get immersed into it. You know, like obviously, you know, there's big ones like Harry Potter and like, you know,
right.
This fantasy world, you know, they're massively huge.
Yeah.
Right.
Very entertaining.
I to be totally blunt, like I guess maybe I just don't have an imagination like
you
that.
You don't.
you know, I'll probably be the first to admit that. You know, I don't want to say I'm very black and white.
Yeah.
But I mean, you know me. I mean, maybe I would be described as more black and white.
Right.
As that I see things. There's either like a right or a wrong, right? Mm-hmm. But the reality is like I'm also very cognizant of the fact that there's a lot of gray area, yeah. and sometimes a lot of life is lived in that gray area,
right.
you know, and it doesn't mean it's like, oh, I'm trying to be shady on one way or the other. It just means that sometimes there's not always like a yes or a no. Sometimes it's like a yes, but with this, or
yeah.
it's a no, but we're doing that. Like, so it,
yeah,
I don't know. I think as a business for me, especially in what we're doing, you know, we are kind of growing a market of people who are uneducated on what we do. And so mm-hmm. a lot of our business is educating people on what we are and what we're not.
Yeah.
And then exposing to them what it could be for them in their world. Right. Mm-hmm. So it's, you know, it's like, well, here's this, here's that. Well, we're kind of presenting another option. And so there's, you know, when you kind of go through that, I think, you know, we're having to be creative on how we describe that to people and how we educate them. And I think, you know, with some people out there, you know, it's like they kind of want to have, you know, it's either this or it's that. And our whole business model is not one or the other. We're like a hybrid of about four or five different industries altogether.
Mm-hmm.
And so, you know, I mean, I think when I say I'm not really creative, I mean, the reality is like, I maybe don't have much imagination, but when it comes to this world of like work and do all that, I mean, we talk about all the time is like, I am constantly thinking about what's the next thing.
Right.
You know, so I mean, maybe I'm more creative than yeah. I give myself credit for. I'm just creative in a totally different world
yeah.
of creativity where people can think about like, oh man, here's my imagination of thinking that, where like reading Harry Potter and me, I look at it or some, you know, sci-fi book, whatever it may be, I look at it and I'm like, I'm totally bored.
Yeah.
You know, it's like kind of like what you're saying is like, when do I get to a point where I actually get to do something here?
Yeah.
Like, otherwise I have to keep coming back to this book to find out what's next, where mm-hmm. it's like, it's kind of giving you that imagination, right? Where maybe my imagination's like, dude, I'm done. Like, give me an answer. Like, what's going on here? Right.
Yeah.
So I don't know.
Which is really funny to hear, because I am definitely the one that has a hard time focusing and like staying focused on a book or whatever. I know I'm not the only one. Hopefully there are other listeners out here that are like me and mm-hmm. not like Anthony over here. But I'll read like,
wow, that seemed rude. We'll clip that and just be like, nope. Hopefully people are like me, not Anthony. And just
no
like, wow.
Clipping.
Okay.
I read like 2 or 3 chapters and then I don't go back to it, or I'll go back to it months later and then forget what I read and have to start over. And then I'm like, eh, I don't want to do that. I'll just start a new book. That's kind of where I'm at. Also, so if that's just me reading, if I choose the audiobook version, even if I'm extremely interested in the topic, even if I want to learn everything about it, my brain will start focusing on something else. And I will start thinking about one of the things that the author, you know, mentioned. Mm-hmm. They're on a completely different topic, but I'm still thinking about that topic that they mentioned earlier in the chapter or something. So then I'm like, ah, shoot, I just missed a whole bunch of other stuff. And then I get frustrated, like, now I have to go back and listen to that part again. So that's seriously my cycle of why I don't think I read or listen as much as I probably should. You know, I definitely have time, like if I'm, you know, doing the dishes or picking the boys up from school or, you know, something like that, plenty of time to just listen to part of it. But I know what I'll do, and I'll just start zoning off into La La Land or something and not really listen. So
did you read comics when you were a kid?
Yeah.
It just sounds like comics might be your thing. It's like very short stints.
Graphic
of
novels. Yeah, I'd be like, I need graphic novels.
Oh, perfect. I got everything I need to know about my day.
Yes. Little devotional daily.
Yeah, see if you can get some like parenting comics going. And be like, here's your daily tip for today.
Wow. Yeah. Sure. I know there's other people out there like me.
Oh,
there has to be. I'm not the only one.
No. And I mean, for me, like,
I just have your brain.
I just try to get, you know, for me, it's like sometimes I'll get, you know, you'll come up with kind of like this random idea, like, oh, it'd be kind of fun to do that. And boom, it sparks with me. And then I just get like very laser focused on that. Yeah. And I will run that thing into the ground until I find out whether that's good or bad. And that is just kind of how I do it.
Yeah. See, at least I do have the imagination. I do have I would say creativity too, to give you a blip of an idea and then you run off with it.
Yeah, that's true.
Yes.
Yeah.
So we want to know which person are you? Are you like one of us, or are you completely different and something we haven't even thought of?
Are you a better version of us?
You are. I'm sure you're a better version of us, actually.
Like, well, I'm better than both of you because I have an imagination and I can focus on my work.
Yes, but for you. Comment. Yeah. Send us an email.
Go on the YouTube, make a comment on this kind of stuff because we kind of want to see. But, you know, I did want to talk about, like, you know, for example, like some of the books that I have in the last, you know, I kind of wrote down in the last really 6 to 8 months, you know, that I've kind of been able to go through. Mm-hmm. There's a few that I'm working on right now. I usually have 2, maybe 3 at a time that I'm kind of going through.
So you are ADD like me sometimes then.
What?
If you are going through more than one at a time.
Sometimes it's like just based on my mood. Like if I'm in a gruff mood, I'll listen to, you know, some more military guys and listen to some stories being told. It just kind of lets me think about that. Sometimes if I'm more, you know, I have a topic in my head I got to think about, I'll listen to type of book. But so there's a few, like, as far as like business goes, it was actually recommended to me by someone, but a book called Clockwork. It's a very informative book on how to get things cycling through your company, to really get things on a schedule. And kind of like the name implies, Clockwork, but it gets into more in depth like that. So that anybody who's like an entrepreneur, anybody who's trying to grow a business, anyone who's got an established business, who's trying to really functionally make things a little more in tune with how things should be operating, you know, Clockwork's a really, really great book. That was a good one that I had. Kind of getting into more of the military stuff, like Relentless by Dean Stott. Relentless was a good one. I read that fairly recently. Another, you know, that kind of rolls into, you know, I have, what is it? Can't Hurt Me and Never Finish, both by David Goggins. You know, his story is mm-hmm. well told, you know, well documented. You know, Dean Stott was maybe lesser told, but in the community of people, you know, he's a well-known well-known person. And so same thing with like David Goggins, you know, it's overcoming a lot of adversity in their personal lives. But then also how that translated into their military careers and then post-military careers, you know, so it's like they've learned, they are people who've lived multiple lives for sure. Right. But their ability to just, I would say they both accomplished extreme physical,
right.
Like peaks, I guess, you know, if they were, you know, part of the pun, but like literally climbing mountains as, you know, kind of part of what they were doing. But it's more like their mental ability to just say, it doesn't matter what's going to happen. Like, I'm just going to go. And so I think I take a lot from that, like the mental side of what's going on. You know, Tim Kennedy, Scars and Stripes, you know, his is more of kind of like a bio of kind of what he went through, but yeah. A lot of lessons in there as well. You know, when getting back into, you know, something, you know, the one with like extreme ownership, the dichotomy of, I'm blanking on the other one, but it's, extreme ownership is like the big one with Jocko Willink and Leif Babin. You know, those are two guys, both from the SEAL community as well. You know, I look at, you know, as far as business wise, you know, like one is like Start With Why by Simon Sinek. That's a good one just because if you're looking at starting a business or you're in one and you're kind of lost and you kind of go through that, as like you sometimes really need to back up and figure out why you're even doing this in the first place. Like you need a reason for this, because otherwise don't. Like I'm just telling you, it's not something that's going to be for the faint of heart. It's not something to go in kind of halfway. Either you're committed to doing this and you need to know why you're doing this. And I think that's a really good answer for yourself internally, a lot less of outwardly telling others, is that you need to have an internal mechanism that says, like, when the times get really tough, and they will, you know, again, I'm listening to a lot of the Born Primitive podcasts and Bear, who's on there, and his ex-wife, and, you know, talking a lot about how they've grown the business. And, you know, even though they're a large clothing company, you know, now it's very, very similar stories of what we've gone through early on. It's, you know, you're sitting down having these discussions about, you know, using our, it's, you know, we've said our story before in the past too, but, you know, of, you know, using, you know, your brother's garden trailer, you know, to try to figure out like, hey, can I go dump your stuff at the, you know, the dump to get all your yard debris out of it so I can use it for delivery of an office. Like, you know, I mean, risking everything we own, you know, to try to figure out how should we move into a facility. You know, when we had $5,000 in the bank and we bought a $4,500 trailer, you know, and it was like, well, I mean, it's just, you know, these are like the very beginnings, and it's just, these are some of those struggles that I think a lot of people just are not willing to put on the line, where we just said, this is what we're going to do.
This
is our why. And then on top of that, it's, that does not mean you're not going to have future struggles. It's just, you know, sometimes it just means there's more zeros behind the decisions, but sometimes they're still just as big, just as gnarly, and just as scary. Right. But, you know, you got to be willing to push that through. And then, you know, one of the other ones I just read recently was a CEO only does three things. You know, that's maybe going to be more applicable to, you know, really truly business owners, even if you're starting out. But, you know, it certainly will help if you've got employees at that time, or when you're starting to kind of grow your company and you're at a certain position where you're no longer maybe an owner, or like an owner operator. You're more of like a CEO position where, your roles do change, and they change quite a bit. And it just means that you have to view and look at things from an overhead perspective quite a bit differently than if you were down in the weeds out there making calls, you know, like while things are happening like that. You have to look at things on a much more broad scale, remove yourself from the battlefield, so to speak, and look at everything that's happening, not just individually within those groups, you know?
Yeah.
So that's another really great one, but that's kind of like a short list. You know, I know I ran off, you know, a bunch. And then kind of the last one I made a note here too, as well, is like, cause I like there are some books, like there's a book called Mindset that I really like. There's another one here that I wrote that was Winning the War in Your Mind. You know, a lot of this, I've spoken to a lot of, you know, special operations you know, community members. And so much of what they get a lot of credit and hype for is the missions, the weapons, you know, the physicality of what they do. And, you know, again, whether you're pro or for, against, that's not the discussion here, right? I mean, I just know that this is a world that I was very familiar with for a long time that I have a lot of respect for. A lot of it comes from the mindset that most of these people have. Yeah. And I say most because, you know, I heard on one another podcast, you know, it was kind of a joke of, you know, look, there's always a turd in a punch bowl, right? You know, it's like, I was kind of chuckled about that, but you know, there are, you know, not all even within that community are created equal. Yeah. It's absolutely the case. But you know, the reality is the willingness to put yourself through something that no one else will. And then even when you get to that point, most of those people fall off.
Right.
You know, I mean, the attrition rate of most of these people is extremely high. You're mm-hmm. talking 70-80%, you know, of people walk away and they're just like, yeah, I'm not doing that anymore. And these were people who supposedly were the best of the best already.
Yeah.
Right. And so now you get this separation amongst that community. Even within that level, you know, it's like sports, it's like with business, you know, I mean, the attrition rate of businesses and fallout rate is massive. I mean, and it's just because people get to a certain point where they're just, it's sometimes it's physically, I, you know, in some cases, maybe that's like monetarily or whatever, but I just know that, you know, for us, you know, I take a lot of pride in the mental side of things.
Yeah.
I love playing the mental war game, if you will, and I don't like losing. And sometimes it means that I'm playing the war game with myself.
Mm-hmm.
And it's, you know, everyone goes through times of question. Everyone goes through times of worry and doubt. And I mean, that I'm not immune to that. And neither are any of these people in the operations community. They'll all tell you, when, if you're honest and you're sitting there looking in the mirror, you'd be like, yeah, I'm scared to death, you know, or mm-hmm. I'm extremely worried about it. But guess what? I'm grabbing that thing. I'm going out the door and I'm going to be the first one through.
Yeah.
Because you just mentally say, okay, I accept it. I acknowledge that. Time to go. You know, and I think that's where, you know, some of these books are really great in preparing you and getting you through some of those things. And that's why I like a lot of these military books, is because they talk about their training that they went through to help with the mental side of it. There's obviously the physical training of things, right? Like, okay, great. You can learn how to, we can make you physically strong, right? But there are some guys and girls in there who are physically extremely athletic and strong,
yeah.
who never make it past the mental side of things.
Right.
And then there are the other side, you know, where you're like, how did that guy, you know, yeah. or that girl make it through that physical training? Because mentally they just said, I don't care what you throw at me. It doesn't matter. I'm not stopping.
Yeah.
Like, you are going to have to put me in the ground to get me to stop.
Yeah.
Great. So sometimes in the business world, you know, it can feel like, you know what, like you're going to have to bury me. You're going to have to physically come to my house and take the keys to my house and take everything I own until I quit, you know? And sometimes you have to have that willingness to just say, I'm going to do this. And then there's going to be a lot of other businesses and people who say, it's like, you know when to walk away, know when to do that. And it's yeah. like, yeah, I mean, I guess maybe a part of me, I hear it and I can understand that, but I can tell you, like, mentally that doesn't compute with me.
Yeah.
Like I just, you know, I don't know. I'm not really willing to just give in,
yeah.
you know? So anyways, that's just like a short list of books. But I mean, again, going back, you know, please, like, you know, send stuff in. Like, yeah. this is supposed to be like a community kind of thing, where this isn't, you know, my hope is that I can give you some books and you can go back and you can read that, help yourselves. You know, hopefully you can send us some. You
please
know,
send like, some that I will actually read.
Yeah,
and that I will read all the way through.
Yeah, some great highlight, you know, like the highlights magazines.
Wow.
Yeah.
Some word searches.
Word searches, you know, like the mazes.
Hey, that works with, that is good for your brain.
It is great for your brain.
Yeah.
Yeah, because you can zone out.
That's right.
There you go.
Hopefully you learned or got some ideas of some books to either pick up or listen to.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, please, like we said, please share some ideas and let us know what you do. Do you read them or do you listen?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Anyways, hopefully you enjoyed this podcast. Please visit us on our website, outdoor-office.com, or follow us on Instagram, Facebook, TikTok. We're starting to have more of a TikTok presence.
We're very TikTok-y.
We're very TikTok-y.
Yep.
So please go find us, and we will see you guys next time. See ya.
See ya.